Because of this book, I started writing. Because of this book, I wanted to write. Because I wanted to write, I started writing short stories. Because I wanted to write, I started writing jokes. Jokes led to comedy. So it's the ultimate recommendation. And if you are ever confused, ever lost, and if you don't know what is the meaning of life, this will tell you what it is.
Hi guys, welcome to Chalchitra Talks. Mera naam Disha hai, and this is our guest episode with Sahil Shah. You may know him from his hilarious stand-up special, Childish Behavior, on Amazon Prime. You may also know him from East India Comedy. Sahil is a comedian, writer, performer, and now also a YouTuber. I love his YouTube channel where he uploads a lot of fun videos and live stream shows such as Unpopular Opinion and Bindo Clock. Vaibhav and I asked Sahil for some of his recommendations on books, TV shows, movies, and even board games. Sahil was very generous with his incredible recommendations, which we split up in two parts. So what you're watching right now is the first part. If you are new here, we are a recommendations-based channel that brings you some of the finest recommendations on books, music, movies, and poetry every single week. So make sure you're subscribed. And with that, let's get right into this episode with Sahil.
Hi Sahil, how are you? Welcome to Chalchitra Talks.
Very excited to be finally called as the 7th, 8th, 9th guest. Every episode, I look at the comments. I'm like, bol rahe, Sahil ko bula? Nahin, thik hai, I will type. Please bring Sahil Shah. He has very funny and good recommendation also he gave.
Aapka kaafi background Rohan Joshi wale se milta julta hai.
Amara, actually, Rohan and I, like now we are doing this pop culture podcast called Binge Clock. Kyunki I realized ke him and I, same thing. We read a lot, we watch a lot. And we love all this pop culture stuff and all this, action figures and all. Only thing is, he has a proper library. I have side pe main books rakhta hu kyunki mere paas jagah nahi hai ghar mein for a library.
जैसे आप बता रहे हो कि आप देख रहे थे कि कौन कमेंट कर रहा है साहिल का, मैं देख रहा था जब आपने डिसाइड किया आप सक्सेशन पे स्ट्रीम करोगे, कितने लोगों ने लिखा कि वैभव को बुलाओ, बिकॉज लाइक मेरे को लगता है 3-4% लोगों ने भारत में मेरी वजह से सक्सेशन देखा था. मैंने कहा कोई
कांग्रेट्स, ऐसे लोग होते हैं, यू नो, इट्स लाइक ब्रो देखना सक्सेशन ब्रो, सक्सेशन ब्रो, सक्सेशन क्या हो रहा है, कोविड देख सक्सेशन मैटर्स पे सक्सेशन.
बट ग्रेट यार, एंड लाइक बहुत एक्साइटेड है हम ये एपिसोड करने के लिए. तो आप बताइए कहाँ से चालू करें, कुछ टेढ़ी रिकमेंडेशंस लेते हैं. मूवीज बुक्स पे तो इवेंचुअली आएंगे ही, सारी रिकमेंड करते हैं. तो आप बताइए सबसे पहले प्रोडक्ट रिकमेंडेशंस करते हैं चालू.
आई वाजंट प्रिपेयर्ड बट एक्चुअली टेबल पे राइट नाउ आई हैव समथिंग व्हिच आई थिंक इज द कूलेस्ट प्रोडक्ट एवर. सी दिस इज अ कैंडल, एलईडी कैंडल, बेसिकली दिस फेक फ्लेम रहता है, बट द बेस्ट पार्ट अबाउट दिस एलईडी कैंडल इज दैट यू कैन गो और बंद हो गया. यू कैन गो, इट स्टार्टेड अगेन. फुल हैरी पॉटर वाइब्स, यू नो. सी आई टेल यू, ओके, दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई वाज टेलिंग वैभव आल्सो, इज दैट व्हेन आई फाउंड आउट दैट आई हैड टू गिव रिकमेंडेशंस, आई मेड अ लिस्ट. एंड व्हेन आई वेंट थ्रू माय लिस्ट, आई रियलाइज्ड दैट देयर इज अ लॉट इन टर्म्स ऑफ थिंग्स दैट मैंने देखा है, आई हैव रेड, आई हैव वॉच्ड, आई वांट टू टॉक अबाउट. सो इफ यू गेट स्टार्टेड ऑन प्रोडक्ट रिकमेंडेशंस, देन वी विल गो ऑन एंड ऑन एंड ऑन, बिकॉज आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स. इन फैक्ट इन माई डेस्क इटसेल्फ राइट नाउ आई हैव गॉट अ टाइनी गन.
Okay.
And I know you guys are saying, oh my god, tiny gun kaise chalaoge, but don't worry, I have tiny hands also.
हमने ना एक टिम फेरिस का क्वेश्चन चुराया हुआ है, थिंग यू वुड रिकमेंड टू पीपल एन इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉर लेस देन $100.
आई फील यू शुड, एवरीवन शुड गेट अ क्यूट लिटिल बेबी योडा. ओके, व्हेनेवर यू फील एवरीथिंग सक्स, you know, I wish someone could make me feel better, and then you see this face, you see this face and this hand is like, hey bhai, hey, he's the, hey bhai, hey. Oh, okay, thank you bhai, thank you so much for taking care of me. And he's like, oh, I love you forever. And I'm like, I love you too. By the way, I have recommended to at least 7 people to get it. Okay. Ooh. When did I buy this toy? I bought it last year. I'm 30 years old, but I told people to buy it. Why? Because it is the cutest thing you can ever have. And just staring at it makes you go, yaar, why are you so sweet? Why are you so sweet? But if I were to give you the greatest product recommendation anyone could ever get, is very simple. Under 1,000 rupees, I would tell you, get yourself a notebook.
Nice.
and a good notebook, because a good notebook will really make you want to write in it. Like, see this, I've got this showing up for myself daily planner.
Wow.
Everything is pretty. You want to write stuff, unplug to recharge, just get something that makes you happy. And I feel of all the products that I've ever bought, notebooks have truly made me happy, because I look at them and I'm like, yaar, I can't wait to write in you. And then for 10 years, I never do. Because notebooks are too pretty to be written in. But yeah, I would suggest product recos, please get yourself a notebook. सही चीज है।
टीडी रिकमेंडेशंस हो गए, अब थोड़ी सीधी बात करते हैं। किताबें आपको किस टाइप की पसंद है? Are you a fiction person, non-fiction person? Which are your favorite genres?
So I am majorly a fiction person, and when it comes to fiction, I really prefer science fiction. I really prefer time travel based books. I really prefer murder mysteries. So I was going through my list and I was like writing down all the books that I had, you know, and I would always recommend, and this is the first book for me. For me, this started my love of reading. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. This book is so special to me because when I first read Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, I was so inspired by it that I started writing a story that was about a superhero called Fartman. Why? Because मैं 12 साल का था. It was the same, you know, the way Hitchhiker started small blue planet and all. वैसे मैंने लिखा था yellow planet, yellow marble. And years later, when I look back, I'm like, okay, it seems like a ripoff. But because of this book, I started writing. Because of this book, I wanted to write. Because I wanted to write, I started writing short stories. Because I wanted to write, I started writing jokes. Jokes led to comedy. So I would always tell anyone, please, 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 please read Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. Please, please. It's the ultimate recommendation. And if you are ever confused, ever lost, and if you don't know what is the meaning of life, this will tell you what it is. It's 42. It's just 42. That is the answer to everything. Another book that really changed my life when I was a kid, Amar Chitrakatha's Mahabharat. Reading this book, I realized, wow, Mahabharat is so much fun, you know. And mera sapna hai ki ek din I want to read the full Mahabharat, matlab the original Mahabharat. Ye jo hai na, ye abridged version hai. Aur isse mujhe sab kuch pata chala ki, okay, this is how happened, when Bhishma died, kaise hua, you know, all the, sorry, spoilers, Mahabharat spoilers. And it's so pretty, it is so beautiful. And for me, I grew up on Tinkle and Amar Chitrakatha. So this holds a very special place because ye pura Mahabharat ka compendium, because of this, I started getting into fiction, I started getting into mythology, I started getting into Indian mythology, which is very fascinating if you were to read it, you know, the original Indian mythology. So these two books for me, my childhood were formed based on these two books. So these are always the top of my recommendation. Weber, tell me, give me one book that changed your life.
Ray Bradbury ki kitab hai.
Hey, Ray Bradbury was also
Fahrenheit.
Yes, great. I've not read that book, but I will definitely read it. Yeah. Disha, which book changed your life?
The one that comes to my mind right now is The Book Thief.
Oh yes, great book. Very, very nice book. For me, like a book that changed my life was, and I recommend it for anyone, if you ever want to understand what India is right now, 1984.
Oh, I love it.
Third eye opened, you know, because I started seeing everything differently. I'm like, you mean to say? And now if you look at everything that is happening with news manipulation, thought manipulation, arresting people before they say or think something, double speak, thought crimes, and you're like, you know what? This is it. This is where we are right now. Sure, not that advanced a version, but once you read this, you start looking at things and you're like, yaar, kaise pahunch gaye hum yahan pe? You know, I used to earlier think, okay, North Korea was like this, or any classic dictatorship was like this, because he took all the dictatorships and he was working on it. But the way we are going right now, and if you read 1984, there's such a strong parallel. And for me, a very special kind of book is a book with the ending that really slaps you on your face. You know, aisa kabhi hua hai ke you're reading a book aur to book ke beech mein you read it, okay, you're reading maza aa raha hai, and then when you read the last page, you're like, oh wow, wow. Maine gaali diya hai kabhi author ko, gaali diya hai. I was reading Isaac Asimov's Foundation, theek hai, third book end kiya na, I remember also I was in Ooty, I finished the third book and I'm like, sala Isaac, ye kya hai, Isaac, how are you so good, Isaac, I hate you so much. The writer in me hates him for being so good. So 1984 ka ending, I would tell anyone, I know it's a long book, it gets tedious, there are points in the middle where I'm like, kya ho raha hai yaar, kya, But when you read the ending and the way those last few words, I don't want to spoil it. Oh, it is life changing.
Yeah, you know, absolutely. Like,
it's genuinely one of the greatest books that I can ever recommend to people.
1984, agar aapne touch kiya, ispe thoda indulge kar sake.
Bol na, please bol. I would love to talk about stuff. I don't want to be the only one talking.
Yeah, so 1984 pe do movies bhi bani hai. Ek to aayi thi jo 1950s mein aayi thi. Ek picture aayi thi 1984 ki, which was shot in the year 1984. Have you seen that movie?
I have seen that movie because that was also the Apple commercial became famous because it was parodying 1984, and that's when Apple broke into the market also because of the 1984 visual. That's also a very, very, very nice movie.
Uska music itna, matlab mere ko dystopia to itna pasand hai na. Like, I just like live for dystopia, aesthetic dystopia.
Even like for, it was so silly, ek show aaya tha, right? Which came under the zone of 1984, went under the radar, bahut logo ko acha nahi laga. Lela. It was a dystopian world and I loved it. I love dystopian worlds. Nice. It's always so much fun to see. And I've read a lot of books about dystopian worlds, but all of them, unka same hi crux hai. If you read 1984 na, that is the ultimate dystopia.
Why
is it the ultimate dystopia? Because it's true.
Yeah,
that's what sucks, because it's the first book you ever read and you're like, yaar main to isme jee raha hu.
Jo aap keh rahe ho ki aap book padhte padhte gaali dete ho, mera bhi ye same ek parameter hai ki oh fuck main kitni baar bolta hu ek kitab padhte padhte, matlab jitni zyada baar bol raha hu utni achhi kitab hai.
Ha, sahi hai. Maine, so what I did was na, I made a list of books, okay, and I also divided into subcategories. So I'm going to read out a few series of books which for me are abhi now, unfortunately I do not have the physical version. I have them on Kindle because I read on Kindle as well as physical, but these books, okay, and if you're watching, these books have some of the best endings ever, where exactly like above, but I have literally held the book and I'm like, oh. Isaac Asimov's The Foundation series, uska the second and third book are amazing, so please do read it. Lee Child ka pura Jack Reacher series I have read all of them, all. But the midnight line starts with, this is the first page. The line goes very simple. There are 21 ways to spot a suicide bomber. He lists down 21 ways, itching, scratching, nervously looking. And the chapter ends with Jack Reacher, who's the main character, was staring at a man on the train. He was displaying 14 of those signs. Chapter one, over. You read that and you're like, what the fuck? Oh, God. So that is one book. Thapa, I finished. Pull off like twat, twist, turns. You're reading and you're like, kya likha hai, bro? Another great book is the third Game of Thrones book. So I was watching Game of Thrones and I said, chal, main start reading. So I read the first one, second one. Theek hai. The third Game of Thrones book in my... I have never chapter after chapter gone, whoa, what are you... Are you serious? It has blown my mind. And the third season of Game of Thrones captured some essence of the book, but there were so many plot twists and turns that the show did not capture. And if you read the book, oh my God, it is like a slap to your face every chapter. American Gods, have you read, by Neil Gaiman?
No, but it's on my list.
Fantastic ending, twist ending. I'm not going to spoil it. There is also Blake Crouch, who has written the Wayward Pines series. Each book ends with a twist ending. Have to read it. Have to. Wayward Pines, it's a trilogy. Please read it. They made a TV show. Read the books first. And the last book that I can think of that blew my mind, there are a lot, but the last one in this is this is a new one. It's called The Silent Patient, where this doctor is taking care of a chick who murdered someone and she can't talk and she refuses to talk to anyone. And there's a twist at the end. Oh, that twist. Oh my God, I'm getting goosebumps thinking about these books, bro. Because like a show, may you see a twist, you're like, okay, cool, wow, great. But a good book, you're on that journey from the start till the end, you know, that journey in your mind, you know, and when you finally hit that twist, I swear to God, you're literally just staring at a book. I remember Midnight Line, I read it in a flight. Flight ke baad, main aisle mein ghoom raha tha, aise mukh khula karke. I wanted to talk to someone. I would be like, yeah, what have I seen? Oh, you have to. Oh my God, what have I read? Another category of books are books written by a certain kind of author. If an author has written that book, I don't care what it is, I will read it. And for me, a few of those authors are obviously Neil Gaiman. That guy, American Gods, Anansi Boys to Sandman. Oh my God, Good Omens. Ah, Neil Gaiman, why are you so good? I write and I have written some short stories, but I never release them. But like when you write stories and you read a good book, you feel so jealous and insecure. You're like, tu itna acha kyun hai yaar? Nahi, itna acha nahi hona chahiye. It's not fair. It puts pressure on us to be a little better. Yaar. This is too good.
Yeah.
So Neil Gaiman's all the books, Blake Crouch, all the books, Lee Child, all of his books, because Jack Reacher as a character is just so much fun. One author I would highly recommend everybody, whoever's watching, please, please, please read his books. If you ever want a very wholesome but happy way of looking at science fiction, slash fiction. Have you heard of this guy called Matt Haig?
Mm-hmm.
Matt Haig has written a book called Humans, where an alien comes to the Earth and then becomes a human and tries to live life and understand what humans are, which is very funny because you're seeing it from his perspective. There is another book called How to Stop Time about a guy who lives forever and he meets other people of that society. The nicest book ever, if anyone wants to read, of Matt Haig. Khula hai yahan pe. It's called The Midnight Library. Midnight Library ka plot, I will explain. There's a girl, she's unhappy with her life, so she commits suicide. She passes out, and when she wakes up, she's in a library. And the librarian is like, you see all these books? All these books are possible lives that you could have lived. Pick up a book, read it, you live that life. And if you're happy, you can stay in that life forever.
Fuck.
If you're not, you can kill yourself and you come back to the library.
Oh.
And she keeps coming back to the library because every life she lives, she's not happy. Oh my God. So good.
How did you feel about the ending of this book?
I really liked it. The metaphor, the way he's played around, you know, with the library and the choices that you have. Oh, the ending was perfect. It was one of those endings where you really feel like, you know what? Man, thank you. Thank you for writing this book. You imagine if I was in this situation, would I do the same thing? Oh, please, 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 please read Midnight Library. My God, I'm going to lose my mind right now. Fine. You know, and this is not even the tip of the iceberg of recommendations that I have to give, guys. Main kya karu? Bahut hai bolne ke liye.
Like, chalte aage chalo aaram
se. Now I'm going to move on to a few other books that I have around physically. Then I'll move on to the Kindle edition. Books that I haven't physically. Now I'll explain real quick. Sometimes I read books and I come off as very intelligent, you know. Oh, 1984. But sometimes I read bakwas. And you're like, I don't know, Sahil, what age is your mindset? But it is fun to read all this. One record in bakwas zone is called The Internet is a Playground by David Thorne. He had a website. I forgot the name. Yeah, 27B/6. This website is a lot of fun. What does he do? Every time someone sends him an email, he replies with a funny reply by spamming them. Now, why is this spider very famous? It's because he had bought something from someone and then he's like, I'll pay you with a painting of a spider. And then it's a continuous conversation of emails between them and him saying that will not do. And he's like, why? What's wrong with my spider? And they're like, it's not enough. So then he colors it and sends it. Basically, he's a troll.
Hmm.
And if you want to really enjoy fun trolling, please, Internet is a Playground, or visit the website 27B/6. Read any of the articles. You'll thoroughly enjoy.
Nice.
Another stupid zone. William Shakespeare's Star Wars. As a Star Wars fan, I wanted to see what this book is. Basically, every scene is done as William Shakespeare. So Luke, but oh, what now? Han, what light thou yonder flash sensor breaks? Luke, I am the father. You know, it's like that. So this is a play written by, if Shakespeare wrote Star Wars. Another stupid zone. Another great book in a very silly zone. All My Friends Are Dead.
Yeah.
And All My Friends Are Still Dead. Amazing series. All My Friends Are Dead is very funny. My wife loves this. This is her favorite book. All My Friends Are Dead. All My Friends Are Dead. Most of my friends are dead. What? Oh. Now all my friends are dead. That's the entire book. It is too much fun. What a great... This and part two. Okay. Another book that comes in the silly zone. Not exact. Okay. This. If anyone ever gets a chance, please get this. His name is Matthew Reinhardt. Okay. Matthew Reinhardt creates pop-up books. And as an adult, I can tell you, this is the coolest thing I own.
Wow.
And I'll show you why. Okay. This is a pop-up book, right? But I'm going to show you the ultimate pop-up. Is this the Batman one? Yeah, Batman. There was Batman. Whoa. And it lit up. What? I'm going to show you all the superheroes put together. Are you ready? This for me, as you have no idea how much joy it brings opening up this book and seeing this, you know, and I'm like, wow. So yeah, please, if you do get a chance, he's done Star Wars pop-ups also. So this is the great book to get. Goosebumps, always big fan. Fun fact, I stole this from my school library, one of the Goosebumps. And ek din mein, I told my mom, dad, pata hai? Chori kiya. Huh. And they said, pata hai? Fuck. I will record fiction real quick and then I'll move on to non-fiction. Okay. In terms of fiction, you guys must have read Roald Dahl, right?
Yeah.
But did you know his short stories existed?
No.
Okay. So this is a book called The Collected Short Stories of Roald Dahl. And before Roald Dahl started writing children's books, before he started writing, you know, BFG, James and the Giant Peach and all, he wrote short stories. And when I say short stories, these are dark short stories. Dark. Wherein a guy is operated and his brain is kept separate and controlled by his wife so that she can have control over his brain while his body is decapitated. Stuff like that.
Nice.
And that's the beauty. And many of them have twist endings. Many of them have twist endings. And that's the beautiful thing when you realize that your favorite author also had this side to them. One of the stories, the one, it's called Switch Bitch. You know, and you're like, Roald? Aap toh achche aadmi the. Ye kya aa gaya? Ye kaise aa gaya? So I would suggest someone please do read these short stories because it is quite a fascinating perspective into the writing process also to see someone who's writing children's fiction also and writing dark short stories. Other books that I would recommend that I have the physical versions of Brain Toppings by George Carlin. If you're a comedian, do read it. It's always really funny. George Carlin genuinely was a genius. Okay. And this is just some of his one-liners and some of his jokes. Nicest book ever. Sorry, not Sahil Osha. Sorry. They sent it to me. My bad. Man Called Ove. This book is about a grumpy old man who hates everyone around him, but through circumstances has to figure out and take care of people. And the way this book ends, aasu aa jayenge.
Nice.
Aasu. Like it's, there are certain books that make you go, whoa. There are certain books that make you abuse the author, as we've clearly discussed. But there are certain books that stay with you. Sometimes you read it and you don't remember the book, but you remember the time of the life you are in when you read it.
Yeah.
You know, and Man Called Ove is one of those books where if you read it, no matter what time of life you are in, you will remember that time because it's just, you feel good about life. And I like books that make you feel good about life. Yes. Because there's nothing to look forward to anyways. Sorry, I'm very, very negative that way. But then it's nice to have books like this that make you feel good about it. The last book for me, so I love pop culture and I love comic books. I love superheroes. For me, my favorite superhero, and everyone who knows me knows, I love Batman. And I love Batman not because of Batman. I love Batman because of Joker. For me, Joker is the best character ever written.
Wow.
Everything about him is just, it's chaos. That's it. There is no like, हाँ मुझे ये करना है कि कुछ लॉजिक है कुछ नहीं इट इज प्योर एंड सिंपल केओस बट वेयर डज द केओस कम फ्रॉम एंड व्हाई एंड दैट इज दिस बुक द किलिंग जोक इट्स लिटरली लाइक सम 100 पेजेस आई वुड सजेस्ट एनीवन डोंट रीड एनी कॉमिक इफ यू डोंट वांट टू रीड कॉमिक्स रीड द किलिंग जोक टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द जोकर्स पर्सपेक्टिव एंड फर्स्ट टाइम एवर देयर वाज अ बैक स्टोरी टू द जोकर एंड आई विल गिव यू अ क्विक रिकैप जोकर वाज अ स्टैंड अप कॉमेडियन Now you see, and no one was laughing at his jokes. No, he was a stand-up comedian who had a lot of troubles. He had a wife who he had to take care of, and he started doing crime to take care of her. And something happened one day and that broke him. And he then kidnaps Commissioner Gordon and he wants to prove to Batman that, hey, you and I are both broken. We just needed one bad thing to snap us, like how the Heath Ledger Joker said, right? It's like gravity just needs a little push. Same thing. You just needed one thing to snap us. Batman's mad moment was what? His parents died. It broke him. He started believing in bats and he's like, fuck it, I'm going to become a bat and fight people. Joker's bad moment, he had one bad night and that broke him. All of us are literally one bad day away from being broken.
Damn.
Yeah, guys, I'm going very dark, I feel suddenly, you know, I'm getting a little existential, you know. Yeah. I feel both Vaibhav and Disha are like,
loving this side of you.
Yeah, so people don't know this. I rarely show that I have this super dark philosophical existential side, but this book, you start, you're like, yaar, sahi hai yaar, you're right. You just need one bad day to break completely. See, literally, yo, that's it. One, sorry, my hand is one bad day. And you're this guy. I can't get it. Guys. Oh my God. I'm getting so many goosebumps right now. I'm getting so many goosebumps.
So cool.
Sorry. Let me just collect my thoughts.
Yeah.
I'm getting very excited. There is so much to talk about, guys. So much. I love reading. And you know, like every normal person, you're suddenly watching a TV show. You're like, chale, aap baad mein padhte. And then you don't read. Or you suddenly start reading and you're like, yaar, abhi TV nahi dekhna. So right now I force myself every day before I sleep, half an hour, in the morning 1 hour. I read, wow. For sure. It's very important that you read. I'm not saying if you don't read, I'm upset. Theek hai. To each their choice, no force. I was discussing with Rohan, we were discussing about Harry Potter, right? And we were talking about J.K. Rowling and how people are like, yeah, yaar, pagal aurat ban gaye. Like she's been saying really nasty things and you're like, J.K., come on, man. And that's why I said, okay, like there are certain books, right? What happens is, yeah, sure. You know, there is a God that has created this world, but after a point of time, you reside in that world, right? So after a point of time, you can stop believing in that God, but you can continue residing in that world, you know? Yeah. So Harry Potter's like that. It's a world in which I don't believe in the God. I believe in the world and I believe in the people who live in the world with me, you know? So I think that's what I love about books is that these are tiny pocket universes where people live with you. And one of the things that really fascinates me about books, which will never happen through a TV show or movie, is that character description aata hai. Aapke dimaag mein ek image aa jata hai. Theek hai? You form an image. Then they say, and then she waved her blue hair. Suddenly character ka blue hair ban jata hai. Yeah. Then her long legs, suddenly character grows. You know, that's the beauty. The character in your head either changes with the description or changes with your preconceived notions of what the character should look like.
Ek cheez add karunga. A question I used to discuss a lot like in these conversations was exact this point ki aap padh rahe ho aaya ki uske blue baal hai. Par maan lo ye line aayi aap 150th page pe ho. Aur maine agar imagine kar liye ki orange baal hai na, तो मैं तो ऑरेंज बाल के साथ ही बुक पढ़ता था. मैं तो क्योंकि मैं वेदर भी ऐसे चेंज कर लेता हूँ कभी कभी, लाइक आई डू दिस डिस्टॉर्शन. यार सनी क्यों हो रहा है, मेरे को अभी क्लाउडी चाहिए तो मैं क्लाउडी.
एग्जैक्टली एक मेरा एक्शन सीक्वेंस रात पे हो रहा है एंड देन ही इज लाइक वी लुक्ड आउट द सन वाज सेटिंग. आई एम लाइक नहीं, रात हो रहा है, इट इज नॉट, दिस इज माय वर्ल्ड. ओके,
एग्जैक्टली.
इट्स beautiful when you come to think about it, or when you come to think about it from the perspective of the character. Can you imagine kal Vaibhav aur Disha, y'all are in a book, y'all are in someone's mind, aur achanak se light band. It's a darkness because the person reading you said aaj raat hai. Or you are blue hair, because why not.
Isme ek question hai, maan lijiye ye bhi ek cheez I'm very interested in. Agar maan lo Murakami padh rahe ho to jo character aapke dimag mein form hote hain, are they Japanese, are they Indian, are they Western, how do you, aapke kya shakle hoti hai unke dimag mein?
Whenever we do read, na, and this is maybe it's me, you imagine the person, not the face. You know what I mean to say? Like if I'm reading like a Japanese character, I'm imagining the character go around, but I'm never focusing on the face. Because if I focus on the face, then I'd be like, kaisa dikh raha hai, obsessed. Unless they are description of the face given. I don't think I've ever put an Indian person level in like a Murakami book. There's this Japanese book, Devotion of Suspect X. Very nice book. Drishyam was the movie that was based on it. I've never read it and been like, yeah, aadmi jaspal hai. Nahin, jaspal hi rahega. It's like you're watching Squid Game, but imagine if everyone was Anupam Tripathi. But yeah, man. Some of the books that I read on Kindle, and I'm not a purist. You know, log kehte hai na, ugh, books are books. How can you touch Kindle? Oh. And I'm like, bro, dono ka ek special vibe hota hai. If you're traveling time to time, and this was when I was reading Game of Thrones, the Game of Thrones fourth book was this big. You can't lug around with it. It makes no sense. That's why you get a Kindle. It's easier to travel. It's easier to roam around. Pull it out, read, raat ko, read. The best part and why anyone should buy a Kindle is because in life, if you buy many books and you don't read them, they pile up and they taunt you every day saying, tune mujhe padha nahi. But in a Kindle, you can never see them. fact, I was going through my list. I had 211 titles, out of which I think I've read 90. The rest are just either half read or completely unread. But do I see them every day reminding me about my failure? No. Are you a purist or Kindle readers?
Both.
I want to be a purist, but I can't afford that.
Yeah, exactly. And also Kindle's cheaper. It's much more friendly. There are so many better
And ways. One plug about Kindle. Kindle पे अभी पता चला है उसमें orientation change हो सकती है. तो Kindle पे आप landscape mode में पढ़ते हो तो मैं तो Yep.
One second. Wait. I'm going to just that. 1 second put it on test. If it happens, I will scream and throw my headphones and run away. Okay? I'm just telling you in advance.
दिखाओ ना स्क्रीन दिख नहीं रही. हाँ. नहीं 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 नहीं. ऑप्शन है. पेपर वाइट है ये.
हाँ.
हाँ. A पे क्लिक करो.
Oh.
A पे क्लिक किया. नीचे तीन चार ऑप्शन आए होंगे. Layout, font, themes. लेआउट पे क्लिक करो. सो बस ऐसे स्टैंड के जैसे मैं सुबह खाना खा रहा था और स्टैंड पे ऐसे आईपैड के जैसे पड़ा है. मजा आ जाता है. बुला लेते मेरे को सक्सेशन स्ट्रीम में. पहले मैं बता देता. पहले दोस्ती हो जाती.
ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रेट. थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू. Very good. Product recommendation, Kindle. Landscape hota hai, dekh. You can't do that with your book. Can you do your book landscape? No. Thank you. Okay. Speaking of Kindle, yeah. I'll give you Kindle records from everything that I have read so far. The one I'm reading right now is a book called Thursday Murder Club. It is basically four old people form a club to investigate old murders. Hmm. And then suddenly there is a murder in their town. So they have to solve it. Lots of fun. Very time pass. Old people trying to be young. Mazedar. Another book in the zone of science fictiony. It's called The Seven Lives of Evelyn Hardcastle. Very simple plotline. There's a guy. He's at a party. There's this girl called Evelyn Hardcastle. And there are different people at the party. She dies. So he has to solve her murder. But when he dies, now this is where it gets wacky. Before he solves a murder, someone murders him. And then when he gets murdered, he is reborn again and time is started at a loop, but as a different character. You know how Cluedo is, right? Cluedo mein you have to solve na kisne, who killed one person. Here, every time he dies, he is reborn as a new character. And from a different perspective, he sees her murder before he's murdered. Oh, 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 oh. It blows your mind because halfway through, you're like, what am I reading? Why am I reading this? What is happening? But that ending, fantastic ending. Trilogies wise, his Dark Material trilogy, Book of Dust, Golden Compass. The Golden Compass, that was the movie also that came out. The show is also going on right now, but it's by Philip Pullman. Please do read it. It's a fantastic, fantastic series to read. Saurabh Pant that recommended it, and I thank him thoroughly for introducing me to that. A parody in terms of a funny science fiction series would be Samit Basu. He has written this thing called the Simokin Prophecies. Okay. And it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. There's a duck called Aishwarya Rai. There's a seagull called Steven Seagull. It's very stupid. It's in that fun parody zone, you know, where like the Eye of Sauron type character gets punched in the eye and then he has to clean it. Kuch bhi bakwas ho raha hai, mazedar hai. It's fun. So he's taken a normal science fiction world and done a parody on it. So Samit, shout out. Another book I thoroughly enjoyed, Ready Player One. It's not the best writing. It is literally writing, reference, but it is fun to read. And why Ready Player One is so meta, and I say that word right now, because it is meta. What is happening with the metaverse is exactly what is going to eventually happen. So Ready Player One is very simple. This guy is in a virtual world and there is a virtual treasure hunt, and whoever finds the key to the virtual treasure hunt will eventually be in control of the virtual world. And he has haptic gloves, he has a full suit, he has VR goggles and a treadmill where he can run on in any direction. All these things exist. Last week they announced that they are finally working on the final stages of R&D for haptic gloves where you can feel things in VR. There is a bodysuit. There is an omnidirectional treadmill. It exists. And that blows my mind that in the next 5 years, this will be a thing. If you go to YouTube, type VR chat. That's an actual game where people can become any character they want in the world and they talk and meet each other. That is exactly what Ready Player One is. It blows my mind when I see books become real. You know, that's the fascinating thing. Agatha Christie, I love her books. And There Were None was a fantastic, mind-blowing, twist-filled book, also known as Gumnaam in Hindi. That was the movie, Gumnaam Hai Koi. Christopher Moore, any book by Christopher Moore also is a lot of fun. He has written A Dirty Job, where basically a guy has to collect souls. It's a lot of fun. I know I'm saying a lot of fun is because I thoroughly enjoyed reading this, and I don't want to give too many spoilers about the books. And there's also Lamb, the Bible According to Biff. Basically, Jesus's best friend Biff talks about Jesus and growing up with him. And it's a funny take on everything, you know. So he's like, yeah, you know, Jesus was a fun guy, but he used to. So it's a very interesting perspective on that entire, you know, the entire Christian mythology. So yeah, these are the Kindle versions of the books that I have read right now. There are a lot, but for me, in the top of my mind, these are some that I would highly, highly, highly recommend. And I will also send a Word document in case people watching are like, yeah, bol rahe. Another book in terms of fiction, which I find really funny, is this guy called Simon Rich. He has written this book called The Last Girlfriend on Earth. And why is that book so funny? I will explain in the next 5 minutes. I will now go to nonfiction. Nice. I do read some nonfiction, I would admit. But my nonfiction is very like, I get very caught up in nonfiction because you're like, kitna yaar facts bologe yaar, kuch interesting bolo na yaar, ye bahut facts hai yaar. A non-fiction book that blew my mind was called American Kingpin. American Kingpin is the story about the guy who formed Silk Road, the online website where drugs could be sold. It was the Amazon of drugs that was available on the dark web. And it's about how he avoided the police capture for years and then how he was finally captured. Oh, what a fantastic story. The way it is written is like a novel. You know, your every chapter ends with, but he didn't know that he was going to be caught. Oh, okay, next page, next page, next page. But he just missed the police. Next page, next page. You're like, what is this? And it's a real story. Very so that's nice. The most fascinating part about American Kingpin. WikiLeaks, it's about the entire story of Julian Assange and how he managed to find info and how they are trying to capture him. So WikiLeaks is also a great one. There's also the Panama Papers, because obviously it's always good to read about rich people getting richer. The good part about Panama Papers, WikiLeaks, and all these books is that they are written by the journalists who uncovered the story. So you get a first-hand info on how they actually uncovered, how a source got in touch with them, how they had encrypted laptops and mobile phones, how they hid in hotel rooms, jumped from room to room, how the police... It's very fascinating when you read how much shit journalists have to go through when you're uncovering something of national security. How journalists of the world come together, you know, to form a forum, and we will all release the news at the same time. So we are all protected. Another nonfiction book I'm reading is called The Emperor of Maladies. That is an entire history of cancer from when it started to where it is right now. And it's quite fascinating to see how humans have evolved in terms of surgical procedures, in terms of anesthesia. Like a great fun fact, OTS called Operation Theater. Why? Because when anesthesia was first introduced, it was like a theater. The person would be operated in the middle and other people would sit around in a semicircle in seats and watch.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh shit, dude, this is mad. So you find out like people used to be operated without anesthesia. Yeah. There's something called radical surgeries. The word radical means that you will, if cancer is, let's say a cancer is a tumor, the person wants to remove the entire body part and keep going deeper and deeper, deeper till everything is gone. So people would be literally without arms or without lower halves in those days. So it's a very fascinating book if you want to understand, because cancer for me is like one of the very, very, very deadly disease, but we still don't have a cure. You know, we figured out everything else, but this is the most elusive one, because the more we try to fix our medicines, the more it evolves. And it's fascinating when you read about it. A few more quickly, I'll read Heretics. Have you read Sapiens?
Padhne ab.
Theek hai, mat pad. It's a long book, very simple. You just read ke humans ye the, abhi ye hai. It's too long. I got bored halfway through. But a book called Heretics, why is it so much fun? And it's so relevant right now. Heretics did change my life only for one very specific reason. So, very simple. This guy, he goes to people and he finds out why they think the way they think. So he will go to a Nazi. He will go to someone who believes aliens exist. You know what I mean? Core philosophy of this, and the Oatmeal also had done a comic on it. It's very simple. Is that when you're born, your house, your mind is like a house. Okay? And all your thoughts that are formed during your childhood and cognitive years are furniture in the house. Let's say my furniture is that I love candles. Candles are the best in the world. Tomorrow, whoever comes and says, mujhe candles achhe nahi lagte. That is an opposing opinion. That opposing opinion is furniture that he's trying to put in my house. But my house cannot प्रोसेस दैट फर्नीचर बिकॉज इट्स बिल्ट इन सच अ वे कि मेरा फर्नीचर ऐसे है ऐसे ही रहेगा. सो आई विल डू एवरीथिंग इन माय मेंटल कैपेसिटी टू फाइट दैट पीस ऑफ फर्नीचर एंड बी लाइक नो फक यू कैंडल्स आर द बेस्ट. And that is exactly left wing, right wing. Anyone who believes in something believes it for a reason. Not only because you thoroughly believe in it, but because your brain is wired to believe that this is the right way to do things. That's why when you argue, sometimes you're arguing with someone and you're like, yaar, ye kab usko pata chalega that he's wrong? But you don't realize that he's looking at you saying, kab usko pata chalega that he's wrong? Yeah. You know? And then you realize that you're not both right.
Yeah.
It's only your house that is different. And that's a fascinating way to look at things. So please do read Heretics. It's by this guy called Will Storr. And I'm going to read two more books for me, which are Steal Like an Artist. 30 page ka book hai. Kuch bhi bakwas. He also has stolen. He's taking quotes from people usne dala hai. So it's a very smart idea. He's written Steal Like an Artist. He's stolen. But it's very simple. It's about creativity. And if you're someone who wants to become a creative person or push your creativity or figure out writing, read the book. Premise is that everyone steals from everyone. No idea is original. Every idea is just a slightly better / modified version of another idea. And if you can steal, then steal like an artist. Take someone else's idea, but make it yours in your own way. Oh, originality is dead. And the last book, someone recommended recently, and this is, I would highly recommend for anyone who is facing mental health issues or who is feeling that, wow, what is happening? How to Be Miserable, 40 Strategies You Already Use by Randy J. Peterson. Every book will tell you, if you have mental health issues, this is what you need to do. This guy says, you want to be miserable, na? This is what you need to do. In his way of anti-doing it, you're like, oh shit. So for example, hey, you want to be miserable, na? Keep comparing yourself to other people. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. You are useless. Everyone else is better. You suck. You need to tell yourself you suck every day. It's very funny. One of the things that is like, you know, everyone keeps on thinking that their future will be like this grand plan. Everything, ke 5 saal mein ye hoga, 10 saal mein ye hoga. Keep thinking like that. Keep thinking. Keep planning for the future. Keep thinking that the movie will continue. Don't think that you're going to die today. So it's so funny in the anti-psychology way. It is actual psychology. And if you read it, right, these are 40 techniques that everyone does. And when you read it, you're like, yaar, tu sahi hai. I think I should not be miserable. By the way, I love reading young adult fiction. And two that I would recommend if you've ever read is Artemis Fowl. The entire series of Artemis Fowl, oh, my childhood was made on it. And the beauty of that book was that at the bottom, there was a language, there was a code. And I knew friends who could solve that code. And it hurt. I would be like, you bastards, how dare you? And another book that I loved was the Bartimaeus Trilogy by Jonathan Stroud about a guy who unlocks a genie. The beauty of that book, every time the genie would talk, there would be an asterisk. And at the bottom, there would be a footnote. Yeah, he didn't know shit. He was just an idiot. And I was like, this is such a fun way to write external thoughts. So yeah, that is so far all the book recos that I can give. I really hope that if anyone is starting the journey and reading books, at least one of the books that I've recommended hopefully changes your life.
Where did this love for reading come from? Who introduced you to reading?
When I was a kid, my folks used to push me to read, you know, and they used to give me books. Started with basic fairy tales. And then eventually Goosebumps ka pura pyar ho gaya. And I have a collection of around 40 of these too. I will never throw away. Archie Comics, Tinkle, Asterix and Obelix, Tintin, Mad Comics. These are all the things I used to read. There was a secondhand bookstore near my house. So every day I would quietly walk. I'm like, uncle, kya hai aaj? And he's like, go. And then in the dirty, this thing, I would pull out some comics. I would pull out some books. And that eventually started into more and more reading, into more and more. And I'm being very honest. When I push myself and manage to read this, right? When I finished this book, I was like, man, I want to read more.
Nice.
Because reading and writing are synonymous, right? The more you read, the more you want to write. The more you want to write, the more you realize you need to read. So it's very important if you're a writer that you read, you know, it's very important that you understand the world, you know. So yeah, hopefully my sapna is one day to write a book. 30 saal ka sapna hai. I have written many chapters and abandoned them, but hopefully ek din kuch na kuch to hoga to.
Very nice.
Fingers crossed. I feel us as a generation are constantly watching, constantly screen pay. Like right now, I'm looking at a screen talking to you people. Why do I like books? Is because for that little bit of time, you are not watching something. You know, you're just reading it. You're understanding it before it actually happens. And keeping that in mind, there is one thing that I love doing. after 2 hours, you feel like your mind has been stimulated, you know. You're like, man, I'm so glad. And I never ever feel bad after doing it. It's called board games. I love board games.
Nice.
Okay. And obviously, there are the obvious recommendations of board games that someone will give, like Monopoly or Catan or stuff like that. But I'm going to give you a few board games that I feel if you're someone who wants to play a great board game in his life or her life, his or her, sorry, I apologize. Please, please. These are some games that I would recommend, okay? And this is as someone who loves games and has an entire collection of them, Splendor. It's a very simple game. There is a marketplace. You have to get tiles. Once you get the tiles, these tiles help you buy cards. Once you buy the cards, each card will have a number on top. First person to get 15 points wins the game. I can promise you, this is a game I learned 5 years ago in a board game cafe. Neville Shah and I were doing a show in Chennai and we played it. And ever since then, I have taught it to everyone I know.
Wow.
And everyone I know has become addicted to it. Addicted.
Wow.
Like people are like, bro, can we play Splendor? Can we please play? They are addicted. And if you're two people who want to play a game that will pit you against the other person and make you be like, yaar, mujhe tujhe marna hai aaj, I will prove my point. This. And it's like chess because you have to plan your moves ahead. Oh, please, please, please do pick up Splendor if you ever do get the chance. I would recommend it like 1000%. Best board game ever to play. This started my journey into board games.
Mm-hmm.
Right? After that, another game that I played. Sorry, I'm dropping everything.
I'm scared.
This
like,
is called,
okay, no.
This is called Azul. Okay. It's a tile placement game. You have these really pretty tiles and you have to place the tiles and form a pattern. Based on the pattern, you get points. Again, very chill, very relaxed, extremely competitive. Please to pick up Azul. This game for me is the most beautiful game I have played in my life. It is expensive, I will admit it. But if you do get a chance to go to a board game cafe, please play a game called Dixit. Dixit is a very simple game. Everybody has 6 cards in the hand. Each person gets a turn. So let's say we all have different cards. And all these cards are weird cards. They have no actual... The illustrations on these cards are art. Some of these cards are so beautifully made. Just look at these. These are all art. Just look at each and every one of these cards. It's art. Okay, all of this, just beautiful visualizations. And the beauty of this game is very simple. One person will look at a card and he'll give a clue based to this card. Someone could say fighting and he'll put the card down. At which point of time, everyone else will put a card from their hand that they think can match fighting. And then there is a voting round for people to find out, did they guess that guy's clue correctly or did someone bluff? And in that mechanics of bluffing, oh, genuinely one of the most beautiful games you will ever play. Like, every time I look at some of the cards, I'm like, this artwork is mesmerizing. I can't believe a game like this exists.
Wow.
If you don't want to take any of these games, buy Code Names. Okay, Vaibhav and Disha, I don't care what you'll do. I don't care what you'll do in life. I want you to buy Code Names. I want you to go right now on Amazon and buy it. It is very cheap. Buy Code Names. And I promise you, if you play this game now, in a month, you will call me and be like, Sahil, thank you. Humne life mein books padhe hai, video games dekhe hai, movies dekhe hai. Everyone has come on the channel and given recos, but no one has ever introduced me to something as much fun as Codenames. Weber, Disha, give me a pinky. You have to promise me. Give me a pinky. Where are you? Give me a pinky to the webcam.
Placing the order right now.
Place it right now. If you want, you'll have my phone number. Call me. I will teach you. I will personally teach you the game. Also, there is the online version also. Go to YouTube, see the tutorial. If anyone wants to play it, you don't need to buy the board game. You don't need to buy it. You can go online. You can tell your friends. You can play it. And right now, because the way things are going, all of us are going to be home. Learn how to play it online. And everyone who is watching, okay, if you do enjoy, I want you to personally then send me a message saying, bhai, tu best hai. Vaibhav and Disha, I promise you, you are going to message. Okay,
very
cool.
Nice.
And last board game, very simple premise. Each person has a certain character and you have to collect coins as the character. You can either be the character or you can bluff that you're the character. And it's a game of how smart you are in bluffing. I know I'm doing a really bad job of explaining all the games, but it's really tough to explain board games because I can't explain it until you've played it. But of all the records, Code Names, because there is an online version, I would highly recommend. And you can play it with as many friends as you want online. So, tu tere phone pe bhi khel sakta hai. तो किसी को लिंक भेज दे, वो उनके फोन के पे खेल सकते हैं. एवरीवन सिटिंग इन द हाउस कैन प्ले इट. जस्ट एक जूम कॉल लगाओ एंड देन यू प्ले इट शेयर स्क्रीन. माय पेरेंट्स टेक इट. एवरी पार्टी दे गो टू दे टेक कोड नेम्स. इट्स रीच दैट लेवल वेयर दे आर लाइक ब्रो माय फ्रेंड्स आर एडिक्टेड. These are my requests for board games. There are a lot more, but I'm just going to keep it simple. Introduce you to the beautiful, fantastic world of board games. And trust me, once you go down this path, now, you just forget anything else exists.